Welcome back. Problem 4-96. This problem is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is the 10 mm diameter shank of steel bolt has a bronze sleeve bonded to it. The outer diameter of this sleeve is 20 mm. If the yield stress for the steel is 640 MPa and for the bronze is 520 MPa, determine the magnitude of largest elastic load P that can be applied to the assembly. E of steel is 200 gigapascal while E of bronze is 100 gigapascal. So you can see this is the steel bolt, clear, having diameter 10 millimeter, and this is the sleeve that is bonded to this bolt having outer diameter 20 millimeter and inner diameter is 10, clear, and their P load is applied on it. So all the values are given. This is the diameter of bolt, is outer diameter of sleeve, inner diameter of sleeve. Sleeve is made up of bronze. Yield stress for steel is 640 MPa and for bronze is 520 MPa, and their modulus of elasticities are mentioned. So you have to determine the largest value of P that can be applied to the assembly. So this is not bolt, this is for the assembly. So let's start with the solution. So what will be the first step is that if you cut the bolt at any section and draw the free body diagram, so it will be like this. At first I will draw this bolt, clear, this is the sleeves, these two are sleeves, and this is dotted line is the diameter, this is the bolt section, clear. So you can see the bolt is applied by a load of P that is upward. So when you cut it, so some portion of this load will be taken by the bolt. This is PB, the load taken by the bolt, and some of the portion of load is taken by this sleeve, which is represented as PS. So we will apply the equation of equilibrium that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So from here we know that P is upward, minus PB which is downward, minus PS is equal to zero. So either we can write it P is equal to PB minus plus PS, or again you can also leave it like this, it's depend on to on you. So let this is your equation number one. Now you can see that this sleeve is bounded with this bolt, clear, so due to this load there will be elongation in sleeve and bolt, and both elongation will be same because due to bonded sleeve we have change in length of bolt is equal to change in length of sleeve. So we know that this change in length of bolt is equal to PB into LB, length of bolt divided by area of bolt, into E of steel, clear, because the bolt is made up of steel. And change of length of sleeve is equal to P of sleeve into length of sleeve divided by area of sleeve into E of bronze, because this sleeve is made up of bronze. So put the value, PB is not known, clear. So PB, LB and LS, LB is equal to LS, both of the same length, that is equal to L. Therefore, these two value will cut. So PB divided by area of bolt, so pi by 4D square, diameter of bolt is 0.01 meter. So it will be in square, D square into E of steel. E of steel is 200 gigapascal, 200 into 10 to the power 9. Is equal to P of steel divided by area of steel, which is pi by 4 D outer square minus D inner square. So D outer is 0.02 square minus D inner is 0.01 and its square. Multiply by E of bronze, which is 100 gigapascal, 100 into 10 to the power 9. So when you solve this for PB, so PB will be equal to 0.667 P of sleeve, clear. Okay, now what we will do is that we will first assume, we will categorize by using two assumption. First assumption is using assume yielding of bold. Yield of bold. So we know that yield stress of this steel is equal to P of bold divided by area of bold. So from here, what you will get is that PB is equal to yield stress of steel into area of bold. So yield stress is given as 640 megapascal. So 640 into 10 to the power 6 multiplied by pi by 4. Diameter of bolt is 0.01 and its square. Clear? That will give you PB. So when you get PB, PB will be 50.265 kilonewton. Now you have this value of PB. So what you can do is that this was your equation number 2. So put PB in equation 2. You will get PS, and that PS will be 75.400 kilonewton. Now you have PB and PS. So what you can do is that put PB and PS in equation number 1. So you will get this P, and this P will comes out to be 126 kilonewton. So this is the load that can be applied to the assembly assuming the yielding of bolt. Now what we will do is that we will apply a second criteria, and the second criteria is assuming yield of sleeve. So we know that yield strength of this bronze is equal to P sleeve divided by area of sleeve. So from here, load taken by the sleeve will be equal to yield of bronze, because this sleeve is made up of bronze, into area of sleeve. So yield stress is 520 megapascal. So 520 into 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by area, which is pi by 4 d outer square minus d inner square. So d outer is 0.02 square minus d inner is 0.01 square. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get P of steel will be equal to P of sleeve, not steel. There is a little bit confusion in this. This P of sleeve will be 122.52 kilonewton. Now you have this value. So put PS in equation number 2. So you will get PB, and that PB will be equal to 122. PB comes out to be 81.68 kilonewton. Okay, now you have PB and PS value. So put PB and PS in equation number 1, which is this one. This one. So when you put it, you will get P will be equal to 204.20 kilonewton. Now this is the load that is due to assuming the yielding of sleeve. Clear? So one P is this one, another one is P this one. So what we will do is that we will choose one which will be safer. So P is equal to 126 kilonewton load that can be applied to this assembly, because this is the largest elastic load that can be applied to this system. And that was all about this problem 4-96. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it. And don't forget to hit the bell icon for getting the new upcoming videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help them in learning process. Thank you.